Water is the lifeblood of civilizations, and its power has been harnessed in various ways throughout history. While China and the United States have both recognized the importance of water conservancy, their approaches have diverged significantly over time. Today, we embark on a journey to explore the historical roots of their water conservancy strategies, an epic tale of ambition, innovation, and evolving priorities. The foundation of water conservancy in China dates back to the ancient Dujiangyan system, a marvel of engineering that has stood the test of time. This ingenious system, built over 2,200 years ago, is a testament to the ingenuity and foresight of the Chinese people. Its ancient wisdom and enduring legacy have inspired generations of water conservancy projects in China. In the aftermath of 1949, China's priorities shifted towards rebuilding its infrastructure, with water conservancy at its core. The country recognized the importance of harnessing its vast water resources to drive economic development and improve the lives of its people. This marked the beginning of a new era in China's water conservancy history, one that would be characterized by ambitious projects and innovative solutions. The rise of hydropower in China has been a significant factor in the country's economic development. As a clean and renewable source of energy, hydropower has played a crucial role in powering China's growth, from industrialization to urbanization. The construction of the iconic Three Gorges Dam, one of the world's largest and most complex engineering projects, is a testament to China's commitment to hydropower. This massive dam has not only generated clean energy, but has also become a symbol of national strength and engineering prowess. In contrast, the United States has a long history of dam building, dating back to the early 20th century. The Bureau of Reclamation played a pivotal role in stimulating development in the American West, with iconic projects like the Hoover Dam contributing significantly to energy and irrigation needs. These early dams transformed the social and economic landscape of the region, creating jobs, driving urban growth, and shaping the course of American history. However, as the years passed, the United States began to reevaluate its approach to dam building. The Great Depression marked a turning point, as dams became seen as engines of economic recovery. The construction of dams like the Hoover Dam created jobs and stimulated economic growth, but it also had significant environmental and social impacts. As environmental awareness grew in the United States, the country began to reassess its priorities in river management, leading to the emergence of the dam removal movement. This movement aimed to restore ecosystems and adapt to new realities, recognizing that dams were no longer the only solution to the country's energy needs. Meanwhile, China continued to push the boundaries of water conservancy innovation. The country's leapfrog development approach has enabled it to become a global leader in dam construction, with technological progress leading to globally recognized expertise. China's modern hydropower network, including projects like Baihetan and Gezoba, is a testament to its commitment to clean energy and sustainable development. In recent years, China has continued to prioritize hydropower as a crucial element of its green energy vision. The country's post-reform hydropower boom has addressed industrial and household needs, driving economic growth and reducing carbon emissions. In contrast, the United States has shifted its focus towards a more diversified energy mix, with a growing emphasis on renewables beyond hydropower. Despite these differences, both countries share a common priority: flood prevention. The devastating impact of floods has been felt across both nations, and as such, flood prevention has become a critical aspect of their water conservancy strategies. In China, rural revitalization initiatives have been linked to hydropower, recognizing the importance of water conservancy in driving economic growth and improving living standards. In the United States, the evolving energy strategy has focused on renewables, with a growing emphasis on solar and wind power. However, the country still faces significant challenges in upgrading its aging dam infrastructure, with many dams in need of costly repairs and renovations. In contrast, China's nationwide water projects have integrated infrastructure with economic zones, driving growth and development in regions that were previously underserved. As the world looks to the future, the historical evolution of water conservancy in China and the United States serves as a valuable lesson. The two countries have taken different paths, but their shared commitment to water conservancy has driven innovation and progress. As the global renewable energy race heats up, China's dominance in hydropower capacity is a testament to its enduring legacy in water conservancy. The United States, meanwhile, continues to adapt and evolve, recognizing the importance of balancing safety and utility in its dam projects. Ultimately, the story of water conservancy in China and the United States is one of cultural attitudes towards water. In China, water is seen as a resource for prosperity, driving economic growth and development. In the United States, water is viewed as a natural wonder to be preserved, with a growing emphasis on environmental protection and restoration. As the world navigates the challenges of the 21st century, the historical evolution of water conservancy in these two nations serves as a powerful reminder of the importance of innovation, adaptation, and cooperation in the pursuit of a sustainable future. While dams and water conservancy projects promise economic growth and energy security, their impact on nature often tells a different story. Let's unravel how China and the U.S. have faced these challenges and the innovative ways they've adapted to protect their ecosystems. Dams disrupt fish migration patterns, causing species like the Chinese sturgeon and U.S. salmon to struggle to spawn. This disruption can have a ripple effect throughout the entire ecosystem, impacting not just the fish, but also the plants and animals that rely on them. Hydropower projects alter river ecosystems in various ways, including changes in flow rate, water level, and temperature. These changes can be devastating to the delicate balance of the ecosystem. China's Gazoba project is a prime example of the challenges of balancing economic gains with ecological costs. While the project has brought significant economic benefits, it has also had a profound impact on the environment. The U.S. has also faced similar challenges, as seen in the dam removal on the Elwha River. This project aimed to restore salmon populations and natural flow, and it has been a success story in the efforts to protect the environment. The Three Gorges Dam controversy is another example of the immense benefits of hydropower projects, yet the environmental consequences cannot be ignored. The dam has been a major source of energy for China, but it has also had a significant impact on the environment, including the displacement of communities and the alteration of ecosystems. Earthquake risks from reservoir-induced seismicity in large projects are also a concern, as seen in the case of the Zhipingpu Dam in China. However, both China and the U.S. have been working to mitigate these impacts through innovative solutions. China's use of fishways and fish lifts has aided migration around dams, allowing fish to continue their natural migration patterns. Ecological flow release technology has also been used to simulate natural river conditions, reducing the impact of dams on the environment. The U.S. has also been relying more on environmental impact assessments to ensure that hydropower projects are designed and implemented with the environment in mind. Soil and water conservation measures have also been implemented in China's hydropower stations, reducing the impact of these projects on the environment. America's dam removal movement has been gaining momentum, with a focus on improving biodiversity and water quality. Habitat restoration initiatives have also been accompanying U.S. dam deconstruction projects, aiming to restore the natural balance of the ecosystem. China's massive afforestation efforts near hydropower sites have also been a success story, with millions of trees planted to reduce the impact of these projects on the environment. Advanced hydrological modeling has also been used to reduce downstream impacts of dams, allowing for more efficient and environmentally friendly designs. Noise pollution and vibration control have also been implemented in modern Chinese hydropower stations, reducing the impact of these projects on local communities. The rise of sustainable hydropower practices globally has been influenced by China's advancements in this field. The U.S. has also been prioritizing public safety and environmental health over inefficient dams, with a focus on removing dams that are no longer serving their purpose. China's dual focus on development and conservation has been striking a delicate balance, with a focus on both economic growth and environmental protection. However, there are still challenges to be addressed, including sediment buildup behind dams, which is a shared challenge for both countries. Innovations in silt management have been improving reservoir lifespan, but more needs to be done to address this issue. Addressing social displacement in large projects has also been a challenge, with China's resettlement programs aiming to mitigate the impact of these projects on local communities. U.S. community consultation during dam removal decisions has also been an important step in ensuring that the needs of local communities are taken into account. Flood control and its ecological trade-offs have been a shared benefit and challenge for both countries, with a focus on finding a balance between protecting communities from flooding and preserving the natural environment. Biodiversity concerns have also been a major issue, with aquatic species population declines due to altered habitats. China's investment in monitoring and research for ecological impacts has been a step in the right direction, aiming to better understand the impact of hydropower projects on the environment. U.S. NGOs have also been advocating for river restoration and dam alternatives, pushing for more sustainable solutions. Eco-friendly designs for new dams have been reducing environmental footprints, with a focus on minimizing the impact of these projects on the environment. The global impact of hydropower has been significant, with lessons from China and the U.S. influencing other nations. The role of technology has also been crucial, with remote sensing and AI being used to predict and mitigate environmental effects. Collaborative projects between China and the U.S. in water resource management have also been an important step in addressing the global challenges of hydropower. By working together, both countries can share knowledge and expertise, aiming to create more sustainable and environmentally friendly solutions for the future. As global water demands continue to rise and environmental concerns intensify, the future of water conservancy depends on innovation, collaboration, and sustainability. The world is at a critical juncture, and it's essential that we explore how countries like China and the U.S. are pioneering solutions for a greener tomorrow. The importance of water conservancy cannot be overstated, and it's crucial that we work together to address the challenges facing our planet. One of the key areas of focus is the development of advanced fish pass technologies that improve migration pathways for aquatic species. This is crucial for maintaining healthy ecosystems and ensuring the long-term sustainability of our water resources. Hydrological scheduling techniques are also being used to simulate natural river conditions, which helps to minimize disruptions to downstream ecosystems. The development of pumped storage power stations is another area of innovation, providing efficient energy storage and generation. This technology has the potential to play a significant role in reducing our reliance on fossil fuels and mitigating the impacts of climate change. In addition, the exploration of alternative renewable energy sources, such as solar and wind integration with hydropower, is gaining momentum. Ecological flow release policies are also being implemented to minimize disruptions to downstream ecosystems. These policies ensure that water is released from dams in a way that mimics natural river flows, which helps to maintain healthy ecosystems. Smart water resource management using AI and IoT technologies is also becoming increasingly important, enabling us to manage our water resources more efficiently and effectively. The rise of multi-purpose dams is another significant trend, as these dams balance energy production with environmental considerations. Enhanced sediment management systems are also being developed, which extend the lifespan of reservoirs and reduce the need for costly maintenance. Collaborative international efforts for sustainable hydropower development are also underway, with countries working together to share best practices and develop new technologies. China's commitment to large-scale afforestation projects near water conservancy sites is a notable example of this collaboration. These projects help to maintain healthy ecosystems and reduce the risk of flooding. The U.S. is also shifting towards river restoration, with a growing movement in ecological conservation. This movement recognizes the importance of preserving our natural resources and restoring damaged ecosystems. Floating solar farms on reservoirs are another innovative solution, providing a dual-use innovation that generates clean energy while also reducing evaporation from the reservoir. Micro-hydropower projects are also being developed, providing localized, low-impact energy generation. Enhanced community engagement in water project decision-making processes is also essential, ensuring that local communities are involved in the development of water projects that affect them. Leveraging big data for water conservation and climate resilience is also critical, enabling us to make more informed decisions about how to manage our water resources. Modular dam designs are also being developed, facilitating easier upgrades and environmental adaptability. Integrating ecological corridors into dam construction is also important, supporting biodiversity and maintaining healthy ecosystems. The U.S. is focusing on retrofitting existing dams with modern, eco-friendly technologies, which helps to reduce the environmental impacts of these dams. China is also leading the way in exporting sustainable hydropower technologies to developing nations, helping to promote sustainable development around the world. Policies promoting efficient water use in agriculture and industry are also essential, reducing waste and ensuring that our water resources are used sustainably. Cross-border water resource sharing agreements are also being developed, fostering regional cooperation and promoting peaceful resolution of water disputes. Renewable energy hybrid systems, combining hydropower with other green sources, are also being developed. The development of biodegradable materials for dam construction and maintenance is another area of innovation, reducing the environmental impacts of these structures. Enhanced floodplain restoration efforts are also underway, reducing flood risks and enhancing biodiversity. Green financing mechanisms are also being developed, supporting sustainable water projects and promoting investment in this critical sector. Zero-carbon hydropower initiatives are also being launched, addressing global climate goals and reducing our reliance on fossil fuels. Advancements in earthquake-resistant designs for large dams are also being made, ensuring that these structures can withstand natural disasters. Global training programs are also being developed, sharing best practices in sustainable water management and promoting international cooperation. Innovations in desalination are also being developed, complementing freshwater resources and providing new sources of clean water. Building a resilient future requires balancing economic growth with ecological preservation, and it's essential that we prioritize sustainable development in the years ahead. The road ahead for water conservancy is a dynamic blend of challenges and opportunities. With continuous innovation, thoughtful policies, and international collaboration, nations like China and the U.S. are shaping a more sustainable future for water management. It's essential that we commit to preserving this vital resource for generations to come and work together to address the challenges facing our planet.